Automation Anywhere's new IQ Bot extraction package enables document extraction to be deployed and executed across a distributed pool of computers. In a traditional IQ Bot setting, documents would have to be sent to an IQ Bot server where documents are processed one at a time. With IQ Bot extraction, users can send documents to multiple machines to process in parallel, increasing processing speed and reducing the cost of maintaining large processing servers. This video will walk through how to set up IQ Bot extraction to send documents across a pool of bot miners and aggregate the extraction results in one location. The process consists of six major steps: setting up the bot miner accounts and devices, creating the device pool, setting up the network share location, configuring the workload management queue, creating the task bot, and uploading work items to the workload management queue. In the first step, before documents can be sent to multiple devices, multiple bot miner control room accounts must be set up and connected to the control room. These bot miner accounts must be assigned a bot miner license and a role that contains workload management privileges. If no such role exists, have a control room administrator create one manually. Each of these bot miner accounts must then be connected to a separate bot miner device. It is recommended that these devices be on the same network. Then, a device pool must be created out of these bot miner devices. Do this by clicking on Devices and My Device Pool as a device pool administrator. Then, click on Create Device Pool and select the devices that are connected to the bot miner accounts. For the consumer, select the workload management role that was assigned to the bot miner accounts in step 1. After this is done, a shared network location must be created that is accessible by all the bot miner devices. This shared location will contain the documents that will be processed by the device pool and serve as the destination location in which processed files will be written to. In this shared drive, divide the documents into as many folders as there are bot miners, giving each folder a unique name. Create another location to store the outputted processed documents. After this is done, a workload management queue must be created to distribute the workload across the bot miners. Do this by clicking Workload, Queues, and then Create Queue. Then, give the queue a name. Add the workload management role as a participant and consumer of this queue. Next, define the work item structure. Work items are the pieces of information that are distributed across the device pool. In this case, the work item structure will simply be a column of folder path names with each row indicating a folder of documents on the shared network location. We can define the work item structure using this simple Excel file. We will create a template from this work item structure. We will give the template a name, select the only column in the work item structure, and then select that column as the one to sort by. When the queue is run, the folder path names will be evenly distributed across the devices, indicating to each individual device which folder of documents to process. Next, let's create the task bot that utilizes the IQ Bot extraction package that will be deployed across all the bot miners in the device pool to process documents in parallel. Specify the work item template as the work item template we created in step 4. Add the IQ Bot extraction engine to the palette. Specify the learning instance you want to use on the documents. Specify the input path as a variable named work item, with the key being the same name as the column name used to describe the file path in your work item structure created in step 4. Specify the output folder as the folder path of the output folder on the shared network location created in step 3. Check in this bot into the public folder. Now, all we have left to do is add the work items into the queue. Let's create a separate task bot to do this. Click and drag the workload insert work item action onto the palette. Select the queue that we created in step 4. Enter the work item value as a folder path containing documents on the shared network location. In this example, since we split the documents into two folders, we have two insert work item actions, with each one a different folder file path. For many file paths, one can create a loop to iterate over a list of file paths to add to the queue. Run the bot to add these file path names as work items in the queue. You should see these file paths ready to be processed in the workload management queue. Finally, to execute the bot across all of the bot runner machines, go to Workload, Queue, and click Run Bot with Queue. Select the workload management queue created in step 4. Select the devices in the device pool created in step 2. Click Run Bot with Queue. Now, the task bot will be deployed to all of the bot runners, with each bot runner running its own IQ bot task, and each IQ bot task processing a different folder of documents. After the task bot has finished running, the extracted CSVs will appear in the specified folder of the shared network location, ready for further processing. IQBot extraction expands deployment possibilities, giving users great flexibility in deployment architecture, optimizing processing speed, and minimizing computing cost.